Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. And today we are going to play with a Somua SM. In my opinion, best autoloader from the premium heavy tanks, right? Better than Trashante for me, better than Emil, better than T-77, and this tank have very, very good thing. It has trollish armor against the lower tiers for sure, and you can clip someone for 1,500 damage, so that's very, very nice. Fellas, I'm not going to lie, I did a warming up rounds, and drums. And after 3 battles, I had 2,000 damage and 100 assisting damage. So that's not the best performance whatsoever. But once again, this is warming up. And speaking about some vehicles, I need to do that, right? Because I haven't played with a Somua in a long time. And I believe that's completely understandable, right? Anyways, speaking about equipment, what we are going to use, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to roll with ventilation and 2 stabilizers. Stabilizers plus ventilation directive, right? I was thinking about turbo, but turbo did not make a humongous difference, so I decided not to do so. I did those test games to check it out, how the things is looking like, and so on, so on. And what do we have here? We have a mine. We have mines from the winning spawn against the tier 8s with no Arta. Call me silly, but I like it, by the way, fellas. I don't know, is it just me, or do you feel some wine infection in the game? Fellas, can you smell it? There is so many Somuas, it's crazy. And once again, this is completely understandable because the advent calendar in a way is created to sing the gold from the game which people got from the Christmas boxes. So the offers are very, very tempting, and since obtaining gold is easier than ever, people is willing to buy the new premium tank either. At least that's what I think, and this is how I am looking into the things. And once again, it's not horrible tank by any means. Although once again, it's not the fastest one. It's a bit slow vehicle. Anyways, what do we want to do here? There is plenty of the Bushwanker Sniper Schnitzel Tank Destroyers, keep this in mind, but in the same time we have a hill, so that's very, very, very important thing for us. Meanwhile, this Russian Light probably is going to think about escaping from the hill, I assume. At least that's what I want to believe. By the way, fellas, you know what? I have 0 Fs given. Skill, are you sure about that? I never ever was so sure, fellas. I never ever was so sure. I mean, watch this. Whenever you are clipping someone, it is the best thing when you are playing with this tank, right? For obvious reasons. And now I am simply going on top of the hill. Yes, I know I lost a lot of HP, blah, blah, blah. I get it. But look. To take the hill is probably one of the most important things, if not the most important thing right here. Truly, trust me on this one, fellas. It is extremely, extremely, extremely important thing. So from now on, what is going to be our goal? Since we are having the hill, since we are controlling the hill, right? We are going to start finding the angles from where we can actually punish enemies for one or another stupidity which they are doing, right? As an example, Somua is right here. So what we need to do, we need to start banging him. He have autoloader syndrome. What that means? That means he wants to make a full clip all the time, right? And this is the worst thing what you can do with autoloaders, to simply turn off the brain and simply boom, 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 boom. Well, usually you will finish the battle like this somewhere here. So, fellas, you cannot get autoloader syndrome, otherwise it's going to be GG and you will regret your life choices, right? Keep this in mind. Keep this in mind. Okay, what do we want to do now? Our mission is to deal with the Gusor here, right? This is our mission. So let's see. Can we find a decent angle for this mother trucker? And so far, fellas, I don't really think we can. Oh, yes, we can. Wait for it, wait for it, wait for it, wait for it. This Gusor will figure out after some time, maybe I can pull back and I can bang the skill. If he will make this kind of decision, we are going to start punishing him for obvious reasons. Meanwhile, Ergashem is right here. That's completely understandable. Once again, wait. Patience is the key. Patience is the key, fellas. And in the same time, we are playing from the winning spawn, right? So either way, this is more likely going to be a victory, and I believe that's completely understandable, right? I told you many times about this map and what do I think about the mines balance overall as a map, right? Meanwhile, our T92 is making a hardcore pressure here, and that's very good thing, because this guy decided to pull back, and since he is pulling back, we are simply using our clip potential to simply punish him for his stupidity. Meanwhile, the Type 59 made a mistake, and we are punishing him into the side. Actually, the gun is saying skill. Wait a second, I did not fully understood what you said. Punishing into the side, beast. And this that was a big middle finger, right? But once again, it is completely fine. This is Samoa, you cannot change it, right? It's just how it goes, it's just how it works. It's okay, we still have 10 seconds left, and after 10 seconds we will start punishing people which is playing around this area, and hopefully we will be able to do that successfully. Meanwhile, what do we have here? We have the guy which is looking directly at us, and I'm trying to snipe his cupola, because why the heck not? Do I have anything to lose? I don't really think so. So we are just going for cupola shots, right? Once again, not the easiest shots to hit, but it's fine. We got extra, I repeat, we got extra shot and a bit of assisting damage. And you know what? I am feeling extremely happy with this battle. Why so? For me, it doesn't really matter. Am I surviving till the end of the game or not? And in the same time, that was 15-2 simulator, which every single of us are having, right? Nowadays, right? It's... just simply World of Tanks Blitz, how I like to call it. Fast, puts 15-1, puts 0-15. And after 4 minutes of the battle, you are getting your tank back. Obviously, for autoloaders, fellas, the best thing is when battle is long, right? But once again, it's not going to happen too often. Anyways, let's see what do we have here, fellas. 3000 damage, 600 assisting damage. We are top by the damage. We are second by experience. And we made 118,000 profits, which is, in my opinion, always a nice thing. Let's go for another battle, shall we? And what do we have here? We have some wine steps against the tier 9s, tier 7. So we are middle tier here. Aha, very interesting stuff. What we can do. And by the way, speaking about equipment which we are using on this vehicle, which is two stabilizers and ventilation, I think this is the right equipment to use. I tried to use turbo. For me, it did not. I did not saw the big difference. But you know, for you, if you are thinking turbo is making this tank epic, use turbo. Use whatever flying F you want. It's completely up to you. That's what I love about World of Tanks nowadays, because you can actually to pick up whatever you want and you can still be competitive, right? So that's nice thing, if you would ask me. Let's see. What the flying gap is supposed to do now? There is no light tanks, but we have Borat. Which is very good thing. Now, as you can see, Borat is trying to spot this side, and he is not too successful with it. No, I'm fake. People is asking, am I real skill? And I am obviously fake. I mean, what the flying F, fellas? What the flying F? Obviously, I'm a fake one. What did you expected? What did you expected? Outrageous. So, we have a humongous lemming train which is making a hardcore pressure here. I do not want to do that. I think I am going to be peaceful sniper schnitzel which is playing over there. I truly don't really think it's going to be worth it to lead the charger, to go with a charge like this. Maybe I am wrong. Maybe we could get the most use in this way. But that's my decision which I already made, right? Okay, we are knocking a couple of trees there and there for one particular reason, to have some kind of camo, right? Which is very important. Oh, bless me. Ooh. Okay, let's see, can we get a decent angle here? Absolutely yes. If enemies will try to make a pressure like this, it's going to be great. Okay, there is only one thing what I can say. Patience, 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 patience. That's it. This is only one thing what we can do, my friends. This is only one thing what we can do. Kind of frustrating, speaking about the waiting time, right? And but in the same time, I think this is the right way to do the things. Main battle is happening here. We have couple of guns here, but whenever tortoise will start making pressure, I mean, every single person which is playing here is going to be dead meat, and no one is going to save him or them from this fate. Meanwhile, our T30 is playing with hardening device, so he have a bit more hit points than usual. Very, very interesting decision, but that's completely fine. And once again, patience, 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 patience. Very, very, very interesting. You know what, fellas? I am patient, but I'm not patient. Skill, what is happening in your pigeon head? Can you please translate that to us? Sure thing. Can you speak in words? Sure thing. I decided not to F with a tortoise or with this IS-3 too, and I decided to make a pressure like this. I will try to take this area here, and we will try to eliminate the Mr. Patton from the game, because if this guy is going to survive, it's going to be a big fat pain in the ass for us. We still have Jack Tiger, Tiger, Oni, and a couple of guys here, right? This is very, very, very important, and we need to eliminate the bloody Patton from the game, because he's literally farming our forces here, and that's very, very bad thing. But once again, I did not react it properly, so I can blame only myself. Meanwhile, what is happening? Enemies are thinking about making a hardcore pressure right here, which is completely fine by me. Honestly, I think it is completely fine by me. So, what we can do, what we can do, what we can do. I am thinking about relocating a bit to the side. Why so? Because I think I can afford it. And I want those enemies to split up a bit. Skill, talk more. How do you want to see the things happening, fellas? I want to see the bushwankers right here, so our guys can actually eliminate the side from the game, because this is very, very, I repeat, this is very, very important thing, right? So, let's go sideways like this. Everything is fine, fellas. Everything is controlled by us. We know what we are doing. Or maybe we don't know what we are doing. This guy is kaboom, he's dead. Beautiful. Somua is playing here. I'm trying to punish him into the turret, but as you can see, sometimes the gun handling can behave like a big pile of poop. We are tracking this guy, and we are tracking this guy once again, and this guy is dead. Meanwhile, STG is playing here, which is completely fine, and we are trying to escape before it's too late, right? I believe our Progetto is going to make a bit of pressure for the STG, so he shouldn't be able to hit us once again, so I'm simply trying to escape, and I did that successfully. Good. This charge worked quite well for us. But, fellas, remember one more very, very important thing. We need to defend the base. Defending the base is going to be one of the most important things, if not the most important thing, right? So keep this in mind. Now the question is, how the flying F we are going to deal with this? How the flying F we are going to deal with this? Okay, IS-3, 2, making a pressure through the middle by saying blah, 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 blah. That's okay. How about this position here? I really want to spot this guy which is going sideways like this. If it's going to be the case, it should be very, 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 very helpful for us. And as you can see, it is definitely the case. So this guy is moving sideways, and we are simply showing the dominance over this guy. 3 for the team. 4 for the team. Come on, don't kill me, let me kill you, thank you very much. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful battle so far. Next, I still have a hope at about me going from the back of Tortoise and saying, that's the dream which I have, okay? But wait, wait, boys, wait, we can do this. Shh. Wait, patience is going to be the key. Okay, Tortoise took one for the team, 3 seconds reload left for us, and oh boy, you are going to enjoy this battle, my friend. So like I said, fellas, remember what I said before. banging Mr. Tortoise. Next, there's T95, but now currently we are waiting until Tortoise will be dead. Tortoise is dead. What do we want to do now? We want to get from the T95S, right? From behind. That's what we want to do. We are politely asking, fellas, don't cap. We are winning. So we are politely asking our team to stop capping the base, right? And they actually did. I am surprised, fellas. I am truly surprised in a good way. That's very, very nice. Okay, so what is our goal now? We are getting closer for this T95, right? That's very, very, very important thing for us. Now the question is where he's looking at. He's looking directly for us. That's okay, and he just shot. So what we are doing? We are trying to track him. We managed to track him, some tracking damage, and now I'm trying to penetrate him into cupolas, which is very, very hard thing, but you know what, no complaints, no regrets. I'm just bursting the standard ammunition towers, the T95, and once again, I know I can load the gold and I can make my life so much easier, but fellas, I am using gold when I actually need it, okay? That's when I am using gold. That's it, finito. Other than that, I am not rushing with that. I am not going I am simply not abusing it unless the tank is horrible as a ball breaker, which we recently marked in the stream, and in fact we marked 2 ball breakers. So yeah, my lovely friends, keep this in mind. Anyways, what we are going to do, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, pixel shot Russia. I said pixel shot Russia. I said pixel shot Russia. I said Russia pixel shot. French? Here we go. That's what we have, fellas. That's what we have. Very, very, very good couple of battles to have a streak like this. It's not very, very easy nowadays when it's 15-1. And once again, in my opinion, this vehicle is quite good. Is it easy tank to play? Not really. But it can be very, very, very nice tank in certain situations, right? So what do we have here, my lovely friends? We have solid 3000 damage, we have 1000 assisting damage, which is once again quite nice. We made 123,000 profits, and for today it's going to be fine, fellas. We are having 2 game session here, and we finished everything with a 3000 damage and 800 assisting damage. So I'm very, very, very happy with it. I hope it gave you some tips and tricks how to play with this vehicle, and overall, I like this tank. And I remember, fellas, back in the day when this tank just came, I did not really like it. I thought AMX 5100 is better. And oh boy, how wrong I was. AMX 5100 have a bit of the... it is faster tank, right? But gun handling, armor, obviously, and everything is better on this tank. Plus DPM, fellas. Anyways, thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill. I hope you had a great time, fellas. And I hope I made your life just a bit easier to buy this tank or not to buy. Thank you very much for watching. Skill is out. See you soon, fellas. Peace.